Good morning, dear students. Welcome to my online classes. Today we'll continue our fourth lesson, The Enemy, written by Pearl S. Buck. So in my previous video, we have seen that how Hannah was puzzled at the two incidents which happened on the same day. In the first event, all the servants, they decided to leave their masters and they set out along with their luggage and left the Dr. Sadow's house. And again, when a officer came in uniform, then Hannah was much scared that she assumed that perhaps the servants might have reported to the police and he has come to arrest Dr. Sadow. So now we will continue the story. The general, and again we have seen how when the officer informed him that the general wanted him to see, as he was declining his health, he is sick. So when Dr. Sadow went to see the general, he narrated the whole incident to him. And now there is a dialogue between the general and Dr. Sadow. The general shook his head. "I had rather not be the test case," he said. He felt suddenly weak and overwhelmed with the cares of his life as an official in times of such as these, when repeated victory brought great responsibility all over the South Pacific. So now the general, as he had already advised Dr. Sadow to be ruthless like the Germans and to be kind like the Japanese, but also he instructed him not to do such experiment on his body. And again, he was overburdened by the responsibility because of the repeated victory. So now the general is bearing or holding a lot of responsibility as general of the army, and now this case of Sadow also created a lot of confusion in the mind of the general. So he is just trying to convince the doctor that he will try his best to save the doctor. "It is very unfortunate that this man should have washed up to your doorstep," he said irritably. Now, by pondering or by completely, continuously thinking over the issue, the general became more irritable and he said that, "Really, it is very unfortunate that the sea has blown this prisoner of war at your threshold." "I feel it so myself," Sadow said gently, and Dr. Sadow also agreed to the words of the general and said that he to himself is feeling much guilty for due to this incident. "It would be best if he could be quickly killed," the general said. "Not by you, by someone who does not know him. I have my own private assassins." Now, the best solution which the general has found, he advised Dr. Sadow that this prisoner of war must be killed. But the prisoner will not be killed by the doctor or any person who know the prisoner. So this murder or assassination must be done by someone who don't know about the prisoner. So he suggested to help him by giving his private assassins. "Suppose I send two of them to your house tonight, or better, any night. You need know nothing about it. It is now warm. What would be more natural than that if you should leave the outer partition of the white man's room open to the garden while he sleeps?" So now Dr. Sadow is giving assistance to Dr. Sadow that he will send two or three of his private assassins to kill this prisoner. And He also suggested him that as the weather is growing warm, so it would be better to keep the door open at night of the room where the prisoner was sleeping. Certainly, it would be very natural, Sadao agreed. In fact, it is so left open every night. Then again, Dr. Sadao agreed to the general words, and he said that the door or partitions of the room is always open every night. Good, the general said, yawning. There are very capable assassins. They make no noise and they know the trick of inward bleeding. If you like, I can even have them remove the body. So now, finally, the general said that my assassins, they are trained soldiers and they are capable of assassins. They will very easily kill that prisoner, and they also know the art of inward bleeding. So, but, and also he asked Dr. Sadao that if he want the body to be removed, then I will instruct my assassins to remove the body also. Sadao considered that perhaps would be the best, excellency, he agreed, thinking of Anna. And now Sadao became very happy that at least this meanings or their trouble is going to over. So now he started thinking about Hana. He left the general's presence then and went home thinking over the plan. In this way, the whole thing would be taken out of his hands. He would tell Hana nothing, since he would be timid. Timid here means coward at the idea of assassins in the house. And yet certainly such persons were essential in the absolute state such as Japan was. How else could rulers deal with those who opposed them? Now, as soon as the Dr. Sadao went back, now he started about thinking about the execution of the plan. And now he wanted to maintain complete secrecy of the plan. He even did not want to disclose it to his wife, as she would become scared of the prisoner's murder. And now Dr. Sadao thought that such ruthlessness is essential among rulers, otherwise how could they rule over the people who oppose them? So now Dr. Sadao finally accepted the general's proposal, and now he is just waiting for the action. He refused to allow anything but reason to be the atmosphere of his mind as he went into the room where the American was in bed. But as he opened the door, in a surprise, he found the young man out of bed and preparing to go into the garden. Then again, for the time being, Doctor refused to think anything, and now he went straight to the guest room where the prisoner was sleeping. But as he opened the door, to his surprise, he found that the prisoner or the patient was standing on his legs, and he was just about to go out in the garden. "What is this?" he exclaimed. "Who gave you permission to leave the room?" And as the doctor saw him standing on his arms, on his legs, and walking out, he badly scolded him and inquired that who had permitted him to go outside. "I am not used to waiting for permissions," Tom said gaily. And now, as the soldier, wounded soldier, was much proudy, so he said that he is not in habit of getting permission or orders from anyone. So still he is very stubborn. And his name was Tom. And very happily and very open-mindedly, he said that he is not used to get any permission or instructions from anyone. "Gosh, I feel pretty good again, but will the muscles on this side always feel stiff?" Now, the patient declared that today he is feeling much better, but there is some stiffness in the muscles of his leg. Is it so? Sadao inquired, surprised. He forgot all else. Now I thought I had provided against that, he muttered. He murmured. But now, as the patient informed about the stiffness of his muscles, all of a sudden Dr. Sadao forgot everything about his plan, about killing up the, all about scolding him. Suddenly, his mind changed and he became just anxious about the problem of the patient. And then he said that, I have already given treatment for this stiffness. He lifted the edge of the man's shirt and gazed at the healing scar. Massage may do it, he said, if exercise does not. So Dr. Sadao has recommended the prisoner some exercises for the smooth functioning of the, for the relaxation of the muscles. But as exercise does not have a proper impact, so now Dr. Sadao suggests him to do some massage. It won't bother me much, the young man said. His young face was gaunt under the stubbly blonde beard. Say, doctor, I have got something I want to say to you. If I hadn't met a Jap like you, well, I wouldn't be alive today. I know that. Now, this prisoner, he was, as he was a young man, he said that he is not bothered about that stiffness of the muscles. And now he admitted that he wanted to say something to the to Dr. Sadao. And what he said that he is very fortunate to meet Dr. Sadao as a very good person who helped to save his life. And now he wanted to thank Dr. Sadao for saving his life. Sadao bowed, but he could not speak. Sure, I know that, Tom went on warmly, his big thin hands gripping a chair were white at the knuckles. I guess knuckles here means joints or not. I guess if all the Japs were like you, there won't have been a war. And simply, Dr. Sadao bowed his head only. As he said nothing, then again, this soldier, wounded soldier, he started talking that, I guess if all the Japs were like you. Now he's just expecting that if all the Japanese is so kind like Dr. Sadao, so there would not have been a chance of war. Perhaps, Sadao said with difficulty, and now I think you better go to bed. Then, with great difficulty, Sadao simply said that perhaps you may be right, but now it would be better if you go to your bed and take rest. He helped the boy back into the bed and then bowed. Good night, he said. Then again, Dr. Sadao helped this young boy to go back into his bed, and then he wished him good night. And now we have seen how this young man, he wanted to thank Dr. Sadao for saving his life, but Dr. Sadao was speechless or helpless because he knew that what he had planned, how he had just managed or prepared his destiny. So he realized that very soon the assassins will kill this young man, and now he is simply thanking, or he is very happy after getting a new life. Sadao slept badly at that night. Time and time again he woke, thinking he heard the rustling of footsteps, the sound of a twig broken or a stone displaced in the garden, a noise such as men might make who carried a burden. So that night, Dr. Sadao slept very badly. So slept very badly means that he was feeling restless, as he was very puzzled with the problem of the prisoner. So he found it unable to sleep. And as the time passes, he woke up many times in between. And now he was just hearing the rustling of footsteps, the sounds of the footsteps, the sound of even twigs crushed under the foot of the people, and sometimes stones being displaced in the garden. And all those noises convinced Dr. Sadao that the assassins had come and were taking the burden away, or they were taking the dead body of the soldier. The next morning, he made the excuse to go first into the guest room. So now, next morning, Dr. Sadao woke up early and he was curious to see what had happened at night. If the Americans were gone, he then could simply tell Hannah that so the general had directed. But when he opened the door, he saw at once that there on the pillow was the saggy blonde head. He could hear the peaceful breathing of sleep, and he closed the door again quietly. So on the way, Dr. Sadao was just thinking that if Hannah will inquire about the soldier, then he will inform that these were the orders from the generals, and he will try to convince and soothe her. But when he opened the door, he found that the soldier was snoring sleep. He was in deep sleep and dreaming. And on the other hand, we have seen how Dr. Sadao was restless throughout the night. He is asleep, he told Hannah. He is almost well to sleep like that. And when he returned back, he was a little bit disappointed. And then he informed to Hannah that the soldier, he is sleeping, and such deep sleep is good for his health. "What shall we do with him?" Hannah whispered her old refrain. Refrain means fatigue. So, but when Dr. Sadao informed that this man is recovering very quickly, then Hannah again repeated her question that, "How will we get rid of this man?" Sadao shook his head. "I must decide in a day or two," he promised. Then Dr. Sadao promised his wife that within 1 or 2 days he will find the solution, and soon they will get rid of this trouble. But certainly, he thought, the second night must be the night. There rose a wind that night, and he listened to the sounds of bending bow and whistling partisans. And again the next night, Dr. Sadao was expecting the assassins. And again tonight, he is hearing the sounds of the wind and also the bending bow. Bow means branches, and whistling sounds of the door, as the door was not closed, so they were just swinging along with the wind. So these sounds can be easily heard by Dr. Sadao. Hannah woke too. "Ought we not go and close the sick man's partition?" she said. And as the sound was louder, so Hannah asked Dr. Sadao that they must go and close that door of the sick man's room. "No," Sadao said, "he is able now to do it for himself." Then Dr. Sadao objected, because he had realized that if the door will be closed, then how would the assassins enter the room? So he simply advised or rejected Hannah's request and asked her that this patient is in good health. If he wanted the door to be closed, he can do it by himself. But the next morning, the American was still alive. And the second night was over when again Dr. Sadao went to see him. He was again sleeping in the bed. Then the third night, of course, must be the night. The winds changed to quiet rain, and garden was full of the sound of dripping eaves and running springs. Sadao slept a little better, but he woke at the sound of a crash and leaped to his feet. And then the third night, Dr. Sadao expected that tonight, definitely the general will send the assassins. And as it was raining, now he could hear the dripping sounds of the water falling from the roof. And also, this night he slept a little better because the weather has changed. But at midnight, he was woke up by a loud sound and he suddenly leaped on his feet. "What was that?" Hana cried. The baby woke at her voice and began to wail. "I must go and sleep." So wail, wail here means to cry. So when Hana also cried loudly, "What is that sound?" So both Hana and Dr. Sadao, they woke up at the loud crash or the last loud sound, which was made outside by something. But as he cried, the baby woke up and he started crying. But he held her. "No. What was that?" Hana cried. The baby woke up at her voice and began to wail. "I must go and see." But he held her and would not let her move. "Sadao," she cried, "what is the matter with you?" But now, as Hana advised Dr. Sadao to go outside and inquire what had happened, but Dr. Sadao, he pushed back her arms and said that no need to go outside. Now, at this point, Hana has realized that there is something wrong with Dr. Sadao. There is something which he is concealing, and so she became a little bit suspicious. "Don't go," he muttered, "don't go." But still, Dr. Sadao continuously insisted Hana not to go out of the room. His terror infected her and she stood breathless. And as now Dr. Sadao, he was in terror. His whole body was trembling. So Hana too felt scared and she again did not went outside. Waiting, there was only silence. Together they crept back into the bed, the baby between them. And again, after that sound, there was a complete silence in the atmosphere. So both of them decided to go back and they sleep. Yet, when he opened the door of the guest room in the morning, there was the young man. He was very gay and had already washed and was now on his feet. But again, after the third night, in the morning when Dr. Sadao went to the guest room, he again found the young man in very happy mood, and today he was just standing on his feet. He had asked for a razor yesterday and had shaved himself, and today there was a faint color in his cheeks. And yesterday this young man had demanded a razor, and today he was in a clean shave, and now his face can be seen easily. "I am well," he said joyously. And today the patient is very happy and he declared that "I am fit today." And he said it in a very happy mood. Sadao drew his kimono round his weary body. Now kimono, again we have seen a long dress worn at night. So now he is just trying to put his clothes tighter on his weary, tired body. He could not, he decided suddenly, go through the another night. He was not that he is scared for this young man's life. No, simply it was not worth of the strain. Now, as Dr. Sadao was fed up that he had waited for the assassins for the last three nights, and as the assassins has not arrived, so now he became fed up for waiting for those assassins, and now he is just thinking for another plan. So he is not scared of the young man's life, as he also wanted that the general or the assassins must kill this man, but the continuous stress which he has got for the last three nights, now he don't want to get any stress further. "So you are well?" Sadao agreed. He lowered his voice. "You are so well that I think if I put my boat on the shore tonight, With food and extra clothing in it, you might be able to row to that little island not far from the coast. Now, Dr. Sadao wanted to execute his another plan. Now he said, "You are a very good person. You are very young. Now, if I can manage a boat and I will fill it with a lot of food and water, then will you be able to row yourself to that deserted island? It is so near the coast that it was not been worth fortifying. Nobody lives on it because in a storm it is submerged with. But this is not the season of storms. You could live there until you saw a Korean fishing boat pass by." They pass quite near the island because the water is many fathoms deep there. So fathom is an unit for measuring depth, and it is equivalent to 1.82 meters. So here again, Dr. Sadao said that you will have to row up to that deserted island, and it is not fortified, means there no one live on that island. And what you have to do, and nobody lives here because during the stormy season this whole island gets immersed underwater, so nobody lives there. But as this is not the time of storms, so you will be safe there. And remember, as soon as the Korean ships will move very close to this island, because the depth of the sea is more at this near this island, so when the Korean ships will pass this way, you can take as shelter and you can safely go back to your country. The young man stared at him slowly, comprehending. "Do I have to?" he asked. And as the young man was listening to Dr. Sadao, he was much surprised. He was trying to comprehend everything, what actually the man is thinking, because it all were just unbelievable. "I think so," Sadao said gently. "You understood it is not hidden that you are here." Now, Dr. Sadao again said that now this news that you are here is not hidden. So nearly everyone know that you are here. So if you want to save your life, it is better tonight you will have to leave this place. The young man nodded in perfect comprehension. "Okay," he said simply. Now the young man, he understood the whole plan and he gave his consent. Now the young man easily became got agreed, and he decided to execute. He decided to work on his plan. Sadao did not see him again until evening, and this was the suggestion which he gave in the morning when he went inside his room to see whether he is there or not. Now, but till evening Sadao did not see him again. As soon as it was dark, he had dragged the stout boat down to the shore, and in it he put food and bottled water that he had brought secretly during the day, as well as two quilts he had brought at the pawn shop. The boat he tied to a post in water, for tide was high, there was no moon, and he walked without a flashlight. So now, throughout the day, Dr. Sadao was busy in making arrangements for the safe escape of the prisoner. So what he did? First of all, he arranged for a very stout, means strong, powerful boat, and he placed food and bottled water on the boat, and he also bought two quilts for the prisoner, and again he tied this boat to the post as the tides were high. So he tied the boat to the post, and all these arrangements he did in the dark, as there was no moonlight, and he did not want to use torch or any flashlight in case he is caught. When he came to the house, he entered as though through he were just back from his work. And so Hana knew nothing. "Yumi was here today," she said, as the servants, as she served his supper. So why now Dr. Sadao all managed his plan so nicely and he went home. He came back at home in the same time, in his usual time. So Hana was not suspicious about Dr. Sadao. And while he was having his dinner, Hana informed Dr. Sadao that today Yumi had come. Though she was so modern, still she didn't eat with him. Yumi cried over the baby. She went on with a sigh. She missed him so. So now here we have seen there is a conversation between Hana and Dr. Sadao. He is only listening and Hana is narrating all the day's work to Dr. Sadao, in which she said that today Yumi has expressed her concern over the baby and she was much worried for our pitiable situation. And also, the servants will come back as soon as the foreigner is gone, Sadao said. So now Dr. Sadao took it as a positive step, positive incident. He said, today Yumi is back very soon. As soon as this prisoner will go away, the all the servants will come back to their work. He went into the guest room that night before he went to bed himself and checked carefully the American's temperature, the state of the wound, and his heart and pulses. The pulse was irregular, but that was because of excitement. The young man's pale lips were pressed together and his eyes burned. Only the scars on his neck was red. So before going to bed, Dr. Sadao again went to see the patient and he checked his temperature, his pulse rate, his heartbeat. So everything seems to be normal, but only the pulse rate were a little bit higher and he assumed that it may be due to the excitement or due to the happiness that today he is escaping from this place. But there was only the scars, the red scars under his neck, they were only paining. Otherwise, the patient was completely recovered. I realize you are saving my life again, he told Sadao. Not at all, Sadao said. It is only inconvenient to have you here any longer. Again, this little boy, he said that, doctor, again, you are saving my life. First of all, you saved my life by giving me proper treatment. Again, you are saving my life by arranging a very safe escape. But Dr. Sadao said that, don't think so. I am not doing any favor to you. I am simply trying to protect myself. Because as long as you will stay here, I myself will be in danger. My whole family can suffer a lot of troubles. So I simply wanted you to go away so that we can have a normal situation in our life. He had hesitated a good deal about giving the man a flashlight, but he had decided to give it to him. After all, it was a small one, his own, which he used to at night when he was cold. So now Dr. Sadao was hesitated, unwilling to hand over torch to the prisoner. It is because he used this flashlight during night when people, in case of emergency, call him. But he was also scared that this torch may create problem to this prisoner, because if he will use flashlight in the dark on that deserted island, he will be caught. So he was a little bit scared in handing this torchlight to him. If your food runs out before you catch a boat, he said, signal me two flashes at the same instant the sun drops over the horizon. Do not signal in darkness, for it will be seen. If you are all right but still there, signal me once. You will find fresh fish easy to catch, but you must eat them raw. A fire would be seen. Okay, the young man breathed. Now, finally, Dr. Sadao suggested him that if you are in need of anything, food, medicines, water, then you have to signal me twice. You have to give the flashlight twice. That is only soon after the sunset. But don't use this flashlight at night. Otherwise, you will be caught. And if you are safe, then only give me single signal so that I will assume that you are safe at that place. He was dressed now in the Japanese clothes which Sadao had given him, and at the last moment, Sadao wrapped a black cloth about his blonde head. Now, finally, the final execution of the plan. So, Dr. Sadao gave him the American, the Japanese clothes, and again, he gave a black cloth to wrap his white head. Now, Sadao said, the young American, without a word, shook Sadao's hands warmly and then walked quietly well across the floor and down the steps into the darkness of the garden. So now, before leaving the place, this young man, he very warmly, very happily shook hand with Dr. Sadao. Means this was his act of thanking Dr. Sadao for his help. And then again, very quietly, without making noise, he very gently, he stepped forward in the dark gardens. Once, twice, Sadao saw his light flash to find his way, but that would not be suspected. He waited until from the shore there was one more flash. Then he closed the partition. That night he slept. And Dr. Sadao was just looking at the prisoner while he was moving. So he saw that one or two times he has used his flashlight for finding the way in the darkness. And then finally, as this man, as he went away, so he simply gave one signal. And finally, this night, Dr. Sadao slept very nicely as the trouble was over. You say the man escaped, the general asked faintly. But the next day, Dr. Sadao went to see or to examine the general. Then he again informed about the escape of the prisoner. So this is the statement made by the general that you say, means he informed that this man has escaped. He had been operated upon a week before, an emergency operation to which Sadao had been called in the night. For 12 hours, Sadao had not been sure that general would live. So now we have seen that a week before, an emergency operation was done by the Dr. Sadao. But at this time, Dr. Sadao himself was not sure that this general will live. The gallbladder was much involved. Then the old man had begun to breathe deeply again and to demand food. And gallbladder of the general was infected very badly, so there was a little chance of his survival. But as he recovered his health soon, now he again started demanding food. Means he is quickly, this old general is quickly recovering his health. Sadao had not been able to ask about the assassins. So far as he knew, they had never come. So now, while they are meeting with general, Sadao did not dare to ask about the assassins or to inquire why the general had not sent his assassins. So far as he knew, they had never come. And also, Dr. Sadao was confident that they would never come. The servants had returned and Yumi had cleaned the guest room thoroughly and had burnt sulfur in it to get the white man's smell out of it. So as soon as the servants knew that the prisoner had gone, so all of the servants, they returned. Yumi she burnt the sulfur inside the guest room so that the smell of the young man may get out of the room. Nobody said anything, only the gardener was cross because he had got behind with his chrysanthemums. So nobody expressed their irritation or agitation, only the gardener, because he thought that now he is late in sowing these flowers. But after a week, Sadao felt the general was well enough to be spoken to about the prisoner. And after a week, again, the general sent for Dr. Sadao, and now as he is feeling healthy, so now he wanted to talk about the prisoner. "Yes, Excellency," he escaped. Sadao now said. He coughed, signaling that he had not said all he might have said, but was unwilling to disturb the general further. But the old man opened his eyes suddenly. So now, again, as the general was inquiring about the prisoner, so doctor said that, "Yes, His Excellency, this man, the prisoner, he was very smart and was able to escape safely from my guest room at night." And on hearing these words, the general, he opened his eyes suddenly. "That prisoner," he said with some energy, "did I not promise you I would kill him for you?" So now, it means that now general has expressed his anger, that if he had made him promise that he will send the assassins, then why he let the prisoner go safely. "You did, Excellency," said Sadao said. "Well, well," the old man said in a tone of amazement. "So I did. But you see, I was suffering a good deal. The truth is, I thought of nothing but myself, and so I forgot my promise to you." So now, Dr. Sadao accepted, yes, sir, you have promised to send assassins for the prisoner, but again, Dr. Sadao, again the general accepted that as he was in bad health, his health was deteriorating, so he simply thought only about himself, and so he forgot to keep his promise. "I wondered, Your Excellency," Sadao murmured. And again, Dr. Sadao expressed his excitement, his surprise that, "I am wondering, how could you forget your promise? This execution of that plan, which both of them had made, was very important." So Dr. Sadao was surprised that how, being the general, being so responsible, how you can forget to keep your promise. "I was certainly very careless of you," the general said, "but you understand it was not lack of patriotism or dereliction of duty." He looked anxiously at his doctor. "If the matter should come out, you should understand that, wouldn't you?" So now, again, the general accepted that really it was a part of carelessness from his side. But again, he wanted to convince Dr. Sadao that it was not due to the lack of his patriotism, or even he was not careless about his duty, but as his health was deteriorating, so he simply focused only on his health and forget everything else. And he also wanted to warn Dr. Sadao that in case if this incident or if this news of the prisoner may go to the higher authority, then what would happen? So complete secrecy or complete secrecy is required to maintain in that case. "Certainly, Your Excellency," Sadao said. He suddenly comprehend that the general was in the palm of his hand, and that as a consequence He himself was perfectly safe. I can swear to your loyalty, Excellency, he said to the old general, and to your zeal against the enemy. So again, Dr. Sadao, now he realized that the general is in his hand, in his control, and he is safe. Then he said that, yes, your excellency, I can trust you. And your loyalty about the country and as well as your feeling against that enemy. You are a good man, the general murmured and closed his eyes. You will be rewarded. Then again, the general said that you are a very good doctor. You are a very good person. So definitely you will be rewarded. I will reward you. But Sadao, searching the spot of black in the toilet seat that night, had his reward. There was no prick of light in the dusk. No one was on the island. His prisoner was gone, safe doubtless, for he had warned him to wait only for a Korean fishing boat. But as soon as Dr. Sadao returned, he saw no signal from the island. So he thought that he had already got his reward, because now the prisoner has escaped safely. Perhaps the Korean boats had taken him safely. He stood for a moment on the veranda, gazing out to the sea from where the young man had come that other night. And into his mind, although without reason, there came other white faces he had known. The professor at whose house he had met Hannah, a dull man, and his wife had been a silly, talkative woman, in spite of her wish to be kind. So now, standing on the veranda, Dr. Sadao was just looking in the direction from where that prisoner was blown ashore by the seas, waves. And again, he was just reminding all his past events, or past days which he had spent in America. So he was just remembering the professor at which house he had stayed, his talkative wife, and all other people whom they met in America. He remembered his old teacher of anatomy who had been so insistent on mercy with the knife, and then he remembered the face of his fat and slatternly landlady. Slatternly means careless. He had a great difficulty in finding a place to live in America because he was a Japanese. The Americans were full of prejudice, and it had been bitter to live in it, knowing himself their superior. So now, Dr. Sadao is remembering those bad days when he went to get his education, and then he felt a lot of trouble in finding a place to live in because the Americans, they saw themselves inferior, and there was a discrimination on the foreign students. And again, he also realized that how the Americans were so harsh to the Japanese. How he had despised the ignorant and the dirty old woman who had at last consented to house him in her miserable home. He had once tried to be grateful to her because she had in his last year nursed him through influenza, but it was difficult, for she was no less repulsive to him in her kindness. So again, Dr. Sadao is remembering that landlady, how she was ignorant and also dirty, but at last somehow she agreed to rent a house to Dr. Sadao, and he also felt grateful to that lady because when he was inflicted with influenza, then she took great care of him like a nurse. But still, he found that her even kindness was repulsive. Repulsive means, due to prejudice, she also considered the Japanese as inferior. Now he remembered the youthful, haggard face of his prisoner, white and repulsive. But as he was forgotten in remembering all these old days, suddenly the bad face of the prisoner came in front of his eyes, white and repulsive. And Strange, he thought. I wonder why I could not kill him. But as soon as that the bad, haggard face of the prisoner appeared before the eyes of the doctor, again now he started realizing that he had made a great mistake. Why had he not killed him? Why he saved his enemy? So there was a conflict again between his mind and heart. Now as his mind was wandering and now he was simply walking with his mind, then now he realized that he had made a great mistake by saving the life of that prisoner, because the Americans are, all the Americans are his enemy. And this prisoner, being an American soldier itself, is his enemy. Then now he is just inquiring to himself, he's asking to his heart that why he managed a safe escape for the prison, for the prisoner. So finally we have seen again Dr. Sadow was in conflict with his mind and heart. So this was a beautiful story in which we have seen how Dr. Sadow finally decided to cure this prisoner of war. It is because of his because of the ethics of his profession. So being a doctor, he must try his best to save the dying person. But at last, due to his patriotism, again, he began to blame himself for preventing or for saving the life of the prisoner. So again, throughout the lesson, we have seen how there was a conflict between the mind and heart of Dr. Sadow. So this is end of the story. That's all for the day. And remember that assignment for this chapter will be given in the description box. Till then, take care. Wish all the best for your PA1. And till then, good night, good day. Take care.